Thank you. This is Apollo Control, 93 hours, 29 minutes, ground elapsed time. Some 5 minutes away from loss of signal with Apollo 11 on this revolution. A wake-up call is expected from spacecraft communicator Ron Evans here in Mission Control, just prior to the time the spacecraft goes over the hill on the lunar's far side. Standing by as we wait for him to make his call. Presently, Apollo 11 is in a orbit measuring 64 nautical miles at Apocynthian, 55.5 nautical miles at Paracynthian. Present orbital velocity around the moon, 5,370 feet per second. Spacecraft calculated now to weigh 70,321 pounds. Still standing by for the wake-up call. Standing by for Ron Evans' big moment as he makes his call to the spacecraft. This being the sleep watch, his job has been rather easy, or at least he hasn't had too much conversation with. Here we go.
Apollo 11, Apollo 11. Good morning from the Black Team. Good morning. We got about 2 minutes to LOS here, Mike.
Good morning, Ron. You guys wake up early.
Yeah, you're about 2 minutes early here on the wake up. Looks like you're really sawing them away.
You're right.
Levin Houston, for planning purposes, you can go ahead and take the monocular into the limb with you.
Okay, I'll tell him. How are all the CFM systems looking?
Levin Houston, looks like the command module's been in good shape. Black Team has been watching it real closely for you. Again.
I say because I sure have not.
Roger. Apollo 11, 30 seconds, AOS will be 9-4 plus 2-1.
9-4, 2-1. This
is Apollo Control. We've had loss of signal from Apollo 11 as it went over the hill. Now tracking through the Madrid station during this series of revolutions. Next acquisition as Apollo 11 comes back around the east limb of the moon. On the next revolution, we'll be at 94 hours, 21 minutes ground elapsed time. Some 43 minutes from now. And at 93 hours, 36 minutes ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control.
We'll be right back.
This is Apollo Control, 94 hours, 21 minutes, ground elapsed time. Should have acquisition of signal as Apollo 11 comes around on the front side of the moon on the 10th revolution. AOS is confirmed. We'll stand by for Capcom's call to the crew. We have data coming in now. After having breakfast and getting all squared away after the night's rest period, the crew will have a rather busy day today, including the first manned landing on the moon. Some of the preliminary times being generated now for maneuvers of the day will include separation at the separation burn at 100 hours, 39 minutes, 50 seconds. Here goes the call.
Standing by. Houston, go.
Roger, how do you read the biomat in the LMP with the LCG on over?
Roger, stand by one. Houston, we have good data on all three crewmen. No, play that. The commander, we do not have yet.
This is Apollo Control following the separation burn at the time of 100 hours, 39 minutes, 50 seconds. The descent orbit insertion burn is now scheduled at 101 hours, 36 minutes, 13.5 seconds. Power descent initiation at 102 hours, 33 minutes, 05.1 seconds. We'll stay up live on the air ground loop and continue to monitor any further conversation between spacecraft communicator Ron Evans here in Mission Control and the crew of Apollo 11, which at this time is likely in the middle of their breakfast period. This is Apollo Control, still standing by as the Apollo 11 is about a third of the way through the front side pass on revolution number 10. Still in the midst of their breakfast period. Various console positions are preparing numbers for maneuver times and attitudes and so on for the day's activity to pass to a spacecraft communicator, who in turn will pass them up to the crew, probably during this pass. Members of the white team of flight controllers, headed up by Eugene Krantz, are drifting into the control room now to relieve the night watch. The black team, headed by Glenn Lunny. Glenn Lunny will hold a brief change of shift press conference in the Apollo News Center in MSC. After the handover is complete, we'll continue to monitor the air ground circuit for any further transmissions from Apollo 11.
Thank you.
Houston Apollo 11, we just had a very good view of the landing site. We can pick out most all of the features we've identified previously.
11 Houston, roger, sounds real fine. And 11, I have your maneuver pad and consumables update whenever you want them. Standing by, and that's the block data on the maneuver pad, by the way.
Apollo 11 is a couple minutes away from this rolling right 40 degrees to roll 122, pitch 229, yaw 0, over.
Apollo 11, Houston, or roger, we're standing by.
Apollo 11, ready to copy.
Roger, Apollo 11, Houston. Here's your block data. TEI 30, over.
Ready to copy.
SPS, GNN, 36639. You're down 48, minus 072, plus 051. You're down 33, 135, 24, 40, 00. Noun 81, plus 32178, plus 06036, minus 01304. Your pitch, 064. The rest is NA. College. 2 jet, 1/6 seconds, and it's based on LOI rest mat. Over.
Roger, TEI 30, SPS GNN, 36639er, minus 072, plus 051, 135244000, plus 32178, plus 06036, minus 01304, pitch 064, 2 jet 16 second, LOI rest matter.
Apollo 11, Houston, read back correct. Your consumables update.
Yeah, go ahead.
Roger, GET 91 plus 30 minus 7% Alpha. Minus 8, Bravo, minus 2.5, Charlie, minus 10, Delta, minus 6.5, H2 total, minus 2 pounds, oxygen total, plus 9 pounds. Over.
Okay, thank you. And on board, we're reading for Quad Alpha, 75%. Bravo, 78. Charlie, 78. And Delta, 77%.
11 Houston, we copy. Apollo 11 Houston, I have your baseline altitude update now. Buzz is ready to copy.
Go ahead.
Roger. Alpha 1 is 500, that's 500 feet above the landing site. Over.
Okay, Alpha 1 is 500 feet above the landing site. Thank you. Just Apollo 11, our cruise status report for sleep, CDR 5.5, CMP 6.0, LMP 5.0, over.
Apollo 11, Houston, roger, we have that now.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control. Still up live with the air ground circuit on the 10th revolution around the moon. Crew reported that the commander had 5.5 hours of sleep during the night. Command module pilot, 6 hours. Lunar module pilot, 5 hours. Now 95 hours and 5 minutes into the mission. Another 27 minutes remaining in this pass until loss of signal. Continuing to monitor air ground circuit. We'll leave it up live until loss of signal.
Apollo 11 Houston. Over.
Houston, Apollo 11, go ahead.
Roger, the Black Bugle just arrived with some morning news briefs, if you're ready.
Go ahead.
Roger. Okay. Church services around the world today are mentioning Apollo 11 in their prayers. President Nixon's worship service at the White House is also dedicated to the mission. And our fellow astronaut, Frank Borman, is still in there pitching, and we'll read the passage from Genesis, which was read on Apollo 8 last Christmas. The cabinet and members of Congress, with emphasis on the Senate and House Space Committees, have been invited along with a number of other guests. Buzz, your son Andy got a tour of MSC yesterday. Your Uncle Bob Moon accompanied him on the visit, which included the LRL. Among the...
Thank you.
Roger. Among the large headlines concerning Apollo this morning is one asking that you watch for a lovely girl with a big rabbit. An ancient legend says a beautiful Chinese girl called Chang'o has been living there for 4,000 years. It seems she was banished to the moon because she stole the pill of immortality from her husband. You might also look for her companion, a large Chinese rabbit, who is easy to spot since he is always standing on his hind feet in the shade of a cinnamon tree. The name of the rabbit is not reported.
Okay, we'll keep a close eye for the bunny girl.
Roger. You residents of the spacecraft Columbia may be interested in knowing that today is Independence Day in the country of Columbia. Gloria Diaz of the Philippines was crowned Miss Universe last night. She defeated 60 other girls for the global beauty title. Miss Diaz is 18 with black hair and eyes and measures 34 and one half, 23, 34 and one half. First runner-up was Miss Australia, followed by Miss Israel and Miss Japan. While you're on your way back Tuesday night, the American and National League All-Stars will be playing ball in Washington. Mel Stottlemyre of the Yankees is expected to be the American League's first pitcher. No one is predicting who will be first pitcher for the National League yet. They have 9 on the roster. Even though research has certainly paid off in the space program, research doesn't always pay off, it seems. The Woodstream Corporation, parent company of the Animal Trap Company of America, which has made more than 1 billion wooden spring mouse traps, reports that it built a better mouse trap, but the world didn't beat a door to its path to its door. As a matter of fact, the company had to go back to the old-fashioned kind. They said, we should have spent more time researching housewives and less time researching mice. And the Black Bugle is all completed for the morning.
Thank you very much. We appreciate the news.
Black Team, we'll be looking for an interesting day with you all tomorrow.
Roger, we'll be going off here shortly, and we'll pick you up in the morning for sure.
This is Apollo Control. Some 9 minutes, 27 seconds remaining until loss of signal on this 10th revolution in lunar orbit. Crew preparing now that they've finished breakfast and gotten a lot of their other items out of the way, such as their crew checklist, sleep status, and so on. Preparing for manning the limb for the second time and preparing for the day's activities, which will culminate in landing this afternoon. Apollo 11 is presently in an orbit with a paracentian of 55.7 nautical miles, apocentian 63.8 nautical miles. Lunar orbit velocity 5,368 feet per second. We'll continue to stand by on the air ground circuit for the remaining 8 minutes of this revolution, or until loss of signal. Ground elapsed time now is 95 hours, 25 minutes. Apollo Control standing by. Thank you.
Apollo 11 Houston, 3 minutes to LOS, AOS at 96 plus 20.
Apollo 11, 96, 20, thank you.
I'll need to holler across to you to get the mission timer going. Do we want to check and get our two mission timers synced? What's this one reading there?
3250?
Okay, this one is 1 second slow down on the LED.
This is Apollo Control. We have apparently had loss of signal from the spacecraft.
Let's see, these things come into command.
Here in Mission Control, we're in the process of changing shifts. Flight Director Gene Kranz and the white team of flight controllers coming on to replace Flight Director Glenn Lunny. The capsule communicator on this shift will be astronaut Charlie Duke. We'll reacquire the spacecraft again in a little over 45 minutes, coming up on the 11th revolution of the moon. At 95 hours, 34 minutes, this is Apollo Control.
Well, we couldn't do that without switch. Well, but you're going to have them in here all the time.
Well, I can't think that that would be a significant thing, though, because why would you ever care to whether you'd hook them up again if you came back and died?
is this LCG check. Verify dipstick visible in red or green band. That's not very descriptive. The red one comes out this far, and then the green one's out further than that. The whole thing is only about that long. It's got to be in one or the other. You can't see it.
There, Michael.
You don't need to take, you're not taking your scissors over, right?
No.
This is Apollo Control at 95 hours, 38 minutes. There will be a change of shift briefing following this shift. We estimate the briefing will begin in about 10 or 15 minutes in the MSC auditorium.
I guess I better take that pocket and the purse. Tell you what, I'll stick those. How about putting those tissues in that box that's got that spare camera in it? Okay. Maybe right handy on this, by the way. Now, what does the tissue box do? Right here. Want to see if the computer agrees with that mission timer?
I did already, but it's
Tammy, the perch, and that Lagerman. And that checklist. And if you'll take me off with Sue Sauer.
Okay. Sue Sauer's off. Audio's off. Whoops. Sorry. Audio's
good. Ready for a little help? Okay. Mm-hmm.
What one? Yeah? Got a roll rate in, 3/10 degree roll rate. Now it's taking it out. Now it's taking it back out the other way.
I'm back on you.
I'm going off.
Okay. What's that?
You refresh?
Okay, stand by. You're on limp power. What? Oh, what time is it? It's 95:54. I guess that's right, Tony. It rattles across the dead band at a fairly high rate. This one? This one? It won't hurt it. Supposed to be close. Thank you. Stand by for some master alarms. I'm purging.